So while the new coronavirus hasn't yet been declared a pandemic, it certainly does have pandemic potential. So one of the systems that we study in lab is another respiratory virus with pandemic potential, and that's influenza. So one of the things that we can learn from the last century or so of influenza pandemics in humans, in comparison to the recent coronavirus outbreaks, is that each of these has one thing in common at least, and that's that they all originated from viruses that transmitted from animals to humans. So this type of animal-to-human transmission, sometimes called zoonotic transmission, has multiple factors that can determine how efficiently or if it's able to take place at all. And one of these factors is the ability of the virus to attach to receptors in the new host to be able to infect their cells. So when a new virus emerges, one of the highest priorities is to try and identify which receptor the virus might be using in its new host. So in the context of the new coronavirus, a lot of work has gone into identifying this receptor over the past several weeks. And there's now quite a bit of evidence showing that the new SARS coronavirus, or the new coronavirus, is using the same receptor as the original SARS coronavirus. And this is angiotensin converting enzyme 2. So the ability of the new coronavirus to bind to this protein in human cells, as well as cells from animal origin, including bats and other animals, is likely one of the keys for its ability to transmit from those animals into the human population. However, there's additional factors that might contribute to the ability of the virus to spread from one human to another. And this could involve how tightly the virus is able to attach to its receptor. So recent biophysical characterization suggests that the binding affinity, how strongly the receptor binding protein of the new coronavirus attaches to angiotensin converting enzyme 2, is actually higher than the affinity for the same protein of the original SARS coronavirus. So this could be contributing to the ability to transmit from human to human. An additional thing to consider when you're trying to predict whether or not a virus will be able to attach to human cells is a phenomenon called avidity. So each virus particle contains multiple receptor binding proteins, and each of these proteins could potentially interact with proteins on the surface of a cell to gain entry. So even though individual interactions between the receptor binding protein of the virus and the receptor of the cell may be relatively weak, the ability of the virus overall as an entire particle may be actually quite a bit stronger. So trying to prepare for and anticipate future outbreaks and pandemics involves a combination of surveillance to try and identify what viruses are circulating in animal reservoirs, but also trying to identify which of these viruses might be most well poised to be able to bind to and enter human cells.